subscribe to my channel Your Tech Bro and hit the bell icon to get the instant notifications about the tech as soon as we upload.
Hello guys, this is Dhanashekaran back here, and in this video we will be seeing some interesting tech from Samsung. And well, in this video we will be seeing the unboxing of the Samsung Galaxy C7 Pro. And so without further ado, let's get started. You see the boxing up in front. This is the Samsung Galaxy C7 Pro that I have been imported it. And this is a gold variant with 64GB of memory and 4GB of RAM. So let's unbox it. You see the phone itself. Just take the mobile off itself. As you see, this is brand new and wrapped up with the cover. Let's just keep it aside. And let's have a peep into the box itself. It has been written Samsung Galaxy C7 Pro. Let's just take it off. You get a pin SIM ejector tool and some regular paper stuffs, and it is written in Chinese as it has been imported. You get a quick startup guide. And a warranty card which is being included in it. This sort of paper stuffs, let's just keep it aside. And let's just move on to the accessories we get into it. You get a normal Samsung in-ear earphone, which is of a low quality. Let's just keep it aside. Further moving on. You get a USB Type-C port, as you see. And the adaptive fast charger from Samsung. You see the output is 5 volts and 9 amps. These are the stuffs that you get inside.
Let's first dive into the specifications of this device itself. This device is powered by 3300 mAh battery, a 5.7-inch Super AMOLED display, and an octa-core processor which is being clocked at 2.2 GHz. And this device has a 4GB of RAM and a 64GB of internal storage. It has a hybrid SIM slot and you'll be getting a VoLTE enabled itself. Moving on to the camera, the front and rear facing shooter is being powered by the 16 megapixel shooters. It has NFC, always on display, and a fingerprint sensor. Let's just get into the physical overview of this device itself. Meanwhile, let me peel off the wrapper at the back. Okay then. And this device has a 5.7 inch Super AMOLED display from Samsung. Let's get to the physical overview. To the right, you'll be having the power button and the hybrid SIM slot. To the bottom, you'll be getting a 3.5 mm jack, a mic, and a USB Type-C port for charging, and a mono speaker.
Moving on to the left, you'll be having the regular volume rockers. To the top, we'll be having just an IR blaster. Well, this device has a 16 megapixel rear and 16 megapixel front facing shooter with a good amount of flashlight and the Samsung branding at the back. As usual, the regular radio antennas. Switching on for the first time, we get this.
And yeah, this is how the device looks like after completing all the setup process as formalities at the first time. The scroll bar is very good. You'll be getting the regular and normal TouchWiz UI, which is being customized a lot from the Samsung S series. And you'll be getting an app menu here. let's go for the settings and check the Android version. Current Android version is being installed in it. And the current version is 6.0.1 and it's running in Marshmallow. And we will be getting Android 7.0 in the future updates. Let's check the storage, initial storage, how much we get out of 64 gigs of internal storage. Let's check the storage first. And we'll be getting 51.7 GB of internal storage out of 64. Okay, let's just get back. And we get to the multitasking area. The multitasking is good in this device as it's powered by the 4GB of RAM. Let's just check for the fingerprint scanning. And it works pretty well in all out conditions. I have just checked it out. Well, it works for 10 out of 10 times. And I have never missed out any wrong or unknown fingerprints here. Well, the overall build quality of this device is pretty good. It is very slim and sleek. Extra care must be taken by the user on this device so that it is very slippery at the back. Case must be used for this, back cases must be used for this device. Holding this device in hand is looking much more prestigious. And one-hand operation in this device is not possible. So these are the factors to be remembered by the buyer before buying this device. That's it for this video, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. Soon an in-depth review on this device will be made on my channel. Wait for this. And if you have not subscribed to my channel, make sure that you have subscribed to my channel to get the latest tech updates and reviews and news, etc.